day two and I'm backstage at Mulberry wearing the fabulous Claridge's Hotel, and I'm going to find out a little bit about how you can achieve that look at home. I'm here with Sam McKnight at the Mulberry Show, and he's going to talk me through about the look that he's creating today.
We've got a few extensions here, and to thicken the hair up, I want a very, very natural, fresh, almost a schoolgirl look. So it's very clean, heavy, with a sort of the tiny bit of Pantene serum on the end and some Frederic Fekkai lifting texturizing spray throughout.
Going to speak to Matthias, who's heading up the makeup here at Mulberry. It's absolutely gorgeous. Could you let me know a little bit how you created it and what the inspiration was?
Yes, inspiration Emma and Edward gave me was that they wanted a girl that's kind of outside, very dewy, it's misty, she's kind of pinched cheeks.
So as you can see, that was an absolutely gorgeous look. The hair was something I'd like to try and achieve at home. I think I've got the length, but the waves are going to be a little bit trickier. So anyway, enough of that. Let's head off now to the next show, which is Antonio Bradi. So here I am with Anthony Turner, who's heading up the hair with John Frieda for Antonio Bradi. Anthony, can you talk me through the inspiration for the look today?
She's a luxurious, rich, uptown girl, but basically she's come downtown for the night. You know, and that translates through the side part, which is a little bit masculine. So the quality of the hair has been blown using the luxurious volumizing mousse by John Frieda. Basically working that into the hair and then blow drying smooth. So she's got a quality to it.
Val Garland, you're doing the makeup here at Antonio Bradi. Saw this amazing red lip, talk me through it.
So it is a red lip, it's called Runway Red, it's from MAC, and what we're doing is just gently pushing it into the lips so that we get this lovely stain, and then we're doing this high gloss glaze afterwards so that the lips are really sexy, really juicy, gorgeous.
Hi, Grazia Daily, I'm Antonio Bradi, and we've just finished work, but have a great London Fashion Week.
Hi, Grazia Daily, this is Yasmin Lebon reporting from backstage at Antonio Bradi. I love the makeup and hair. I just thought, you know, with clothes like that, you just don't need to overcook it at all. I think it's really refreshing to have the girls look like themselves.
So we're off to Topshop now, leaving behind this amazing Antonio Bradi venue and that red lip, which I just can't stop thinking about. But as soon as it's released, we'll let you guys know. It's the last show of the day, which is at the Topshop show space for the Topshop Unique Show. It's a bit of a crazy theme today. It's all about Dalmatian. So let's find out a little bit about what they're doing beauty-wise. So I'm going to jump in and speak to Hannah Murray, who's heading up the Topshop makeup team. So Hannah, can you talk me through this amazing, cute look?
We're doing Dalmatian chic this season, that's what I'm calling it. So it's gorgeous, heavy, black eye, all done with kohl, kind of a bit lived in, but still sophisticated. There's a lot of Dalmatian print, obviously the little ears. It's toasty, it's playful, it's Topshop.
I'm going to grab some time with Sophie Robson, who's doing the amazing Dalmatian nails here at Topshop. So Sophie, can you tell me how many girls you're working on, how you're creating the look?
We've got like 40 girls, I think, so it's been a bit of a stress. We've used like a white matte base, and then we're using the Topshop black to do the Dalmatian dots.
I'm here with the amazing Paul Hanlon, who's done the amazing hair at Topshop. Can you talk us through the inspirations, how you did it, how many girls there were?
It was inspired by Walt Disney. Originally the clothes is all like based on the 101 Dalmatians, but we went for more like Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse girls. We made it very, very clean, using really beautiful black velvet ribbon to make little bows in their hair.
So was the end of day two of London Fashion Week, and it's finishing off at Topshop Unique, which has been so much fun, so cute, so quirky. I've absolutely loved every element of it. See you all tomorrow, where it's going to be lots more fun and games in the beauty department.